This program is rated 13, recommended for family viewing.
Ngwira mu banyankole bagamba abanyankole bagatya murije ne ngwira mu batoro abatoro ne bagamba bagamba batya de nina abanyarwanda abagamba ebite byawe nonzira motya
ebite byawe
ni visa achogere chogere ebite byawe ebite byawe ni visa no manyo oruvugo runyagwanda imana yanje urakoze cyane okiraba ate neva yeyo ngenda ne waffe
tuli ku imana zani wano zitogera
ezanje
ezamwe
emikisa ja Yesu nawo olina by the way
twele imana Imani kuwa mtisa.
Nenda. Ya tuwale mbuzi. Nse kati wano.
Indako, imani ya kula
sisi. Ya tuwale mbuzi ya nangu.
Gono ya mbandani imani tunatuwa.
Nse mkuselebrating a Uganda nesi yangi. Uruwale rosa ze wonsi jukirebi seri ya makongo webacha kile Uganda wano. Around 1993, 1994, 1995, paka mungkumi bili nga wakamilion vaze, neba ragadi. Tuwai tuulido mziki guwa wa Kongo. Nilangu kwamba
ni stage
nga chino. Nga, mbombole ya zango. Tinti.
Tene, so ina mziki guwa wa Kongo hawe. Nga zina nga mchevi sili.
Zombo ya nga katinga, okuzino olugundi, ngo inoso kano nofunya mko katinibo.
They mimic the monkey, you know, their dances around the monkey. Simanya wabajidia.
Mzijukira awilo longomba, enyimba ze ya wogani.
Duyimbe, duyimbe.
Awilo longomba.
Arasile yimba.
Cash, cash, cash,
cash.
Awilo. If you say that you are now going to try celebrating our enyimba ze wa Kongo, and you know, every bar you'd go to, every place you'd go to, you know, you'd see people celebrating music.
I remember, because for me, I was born in 1985. I'm not afraid to say. 1985. 1985. Tuwa belanga woku. Tuwa belanga woku flatza Sheraton. Ukumpimpi za National Water. Nga we crossed to a club, bajita nga the Big Five Club. Nga diyo msajia CBDN party. Na yenga buwakuba sebo, ukuba na yo muziki. Kati our parents one time found us there. Nebadi ukaba tuweleza soda. Soda ya ringa noza kubisa tuwe na kwezo. They sent us a soda. Katulibuana buto. Netubuzanyani. The waitresses and waiters were a bit more friendly than they are these days. So they say, those people there, man, we turned it was our father and mother. I just said, we are dead. Dead,
hey, dead. Hey, we said, we are nga besala
mbini. Nengo muziki. I'm an afro. Onyukila afro. Unapologetic afros.
Nja kwe sarako wano afro ku one of these Wednesdays.
Nange binongenda nyiga
mbi jeyo. Afro za wakazi wa fiku.
Na ate gwa banda sama afro ya mchala wono.
Sama ya mchala wono.
Wano sama ya.
Kati, for me, this morning, I was, I smiled at myself because I was remembering the silly things we do, growing up. See, nadaba film where I was past puberty. Then there was one anger. It is a nice scene. She's shaving her legs. Nange ne nkwata shave ne shaving ebigere.
Ngo shaving at.
Maguru wano we but anti mwebiri mu film by the way. Ne shaving maguru. Never like after 3 days of the hair start growing back. But nange lije buri prickly. So I sat back and I asked myself, why am I so stupid?
Like shave your legs.
Hey, and there are stupid things you guys have done. Like,
I was polluted with the westernization that we started accepting pornography. I mean, twina never silica about porn video. Government, but this is the kingdom here. They have their uncle kingdom.
Annex kingdom. Bajirina. 7-7.
But in all celebrating Ugandanese, you know, tachiri kufefeka. If you're at home and you know you feel like you want to celebrate your Ugandanese, you know, type of way. Owe yamba dengaba ni gaba 2015-16 yao. Zukile miaka jafe jonga tuli hiyo pamuchi. Mana besa limpali pake nuwasi wa mbae. And now so celebrating ayo Uganda. Next look back afana ni kiching.
Na katuweleza. Na katuweleza. Na
katuweleza. Netukala gawa noncho celebrating ze Uganda next year wotyo.
Atena watelo kwa kwenye chukomando for breakfast. Watelo kwa kwenye chukomando for breakfast. Na wekuli akafana nyako.
Deriki.
By the way, it is so Ugandan. It is so Ugandan. Actually, a large percentage of the situation, at least of population, at least in urban areas, Tulia Rolex. A huge percentage of us.
Bambi, it is a bit complicated for a lady. I'm a zokte ako lipstick. Tu inengeje tu ino kwa samo kulia Rolex. No comment in
That is like it's unique to Uganda.
I mean, we fish on the unique road. There are potholes in the road. We fish there.
Where have they?
No kwate chenyanja chenyanja.
Na nabye kubole na mirembe road. Baba. Bali koze.
Nesi bwe.
Tansubire quality. will probably be there
we
for about 6 years.
We shall see when people start drowning in a few.
Yeah.
Namirembe Road. Tambula, Wokwe, Buchi, Aha.
Usanga bandi tutendona okuvugira obugali and later on today on the show we'll be talking to a particular lady who has of course mastered the art and has been doing cycling as far as the environment is concerned, all that and much more coming in right here on today's show. But getting into our starting news for the very first time, okay, not for the very first time, but I am supporting the Buganda Road Court. What have they done? Apparently, man has been remanded for making substandard mattresses. Buganda Road Court has denied bail to Moses Waswa, 31 years of age, who is facing one count of manufacturing and selling over non-conforming mattresses, contrary to the section of the Uganda National Bureau of Standards Act as amended 2013. Upon denying the charge, the accused applied for bail and presented three sureties as guaranteed for one to be granted bail. But the presiding magistrate, Miss Marion Mangeni, denied him bail on grounds that the LC1 letters the sureties presented were not corresponding with their places of residence. They mentioned before court, Miss Mangeni said that the bail to be granted the sureties need to be truthful. Two of them, of the sureties claimed to be residents of Mperere in Wakiso. However, their local council and letters are from Buganda Road. The accused is hereby denied bail. And also, Katinyanzo Muntu Wawansi and Songa Dajanani Wade, Nampao Kutinanga Bail, or Muntu and Novinam Fali Sogano.
So, we are a very corrupt, and I'm going to say, yes, Willis, I love my country.
You
I love my Ugandanness.
You are corrupt.
Because I'm not taking myself out of Uganda. I'm not going to change
corrupt.
Because I am living among corrupt people. You guys are Temurwa na you're corrupt.
No.
Anyway.
No.
Wano I am Sbambi, waswate ya manya anti abayi no kutema. Wano we are living ninda kongenda kubulira. Sa wano we nkugamba anti Rolex, ku street. Ngendo nguye Rolex ya 15. Kati gwe mpadde ogenda kutuka yo ngambo. Ngambe nti Rolex mwana bajongezamu kati ya bidi. Kati atenze we nange we mbasi situmye nga yange ya muntu mulamanya ina mko kasente. Okujimtu ayira mwe halero mwana majigabuze. Rolex ya meka bidi bitano. So we keep inflating things like that. Budi omwa aba inaka atema. Kati bambe no waswa. Eno mattress factory. Chances are very high that there are many others who are running these fake things. You understand?
But
teyate mye muchanos.
But now this is a free economy. That's number one. Mm-hmm. When you're selling someone for a Rolex, please put into your mind that it's a free economy. Mm-hmm. Today, Rolex can be at 1K. Tomorrow, it can be at 3.5. And the other day, it can go back to 800 shillings. Mm-hmm. Another thing is that we are largely an informal economy.
Go back to 800 shillings, OBJ.
Yeah, it's all kuka. So another thing is that we are largely an informal economy. Nti omuntu ainzo kuinvesting his time in transporting a Rolex. Mm-hmm. So, guobo sobi na chomuto yego tumie Rolex, agena kuliawa. Rolex oji kuletira, agena tambulao, injala temulume after that, I know kunywa kumazizi. That means, nja ino tuka ya kugaya Rolex ya bidi bitia. Ebitano bimu transporting, that's not corruption.
No, it is actually corruption. But in any sense, I do not agree with this. I don't agree with this people who make fake products. You guys, you're killing us. Because at the end of the day, no one who agenda causes some fire so gumu. And then your own child is also seeing you making fake things. So it's going to be a chain of fakeness. There will be fake people, fake hats, fake everything. At some point, fakeness has to stop.
You know, mattress is now all it needs changing.
A mattress can work up to 3 years, I think.
Yes,
an original mattress can work up.
Auntie, if I saw Jawokana, what were just spring? What year just foam? What year just cotton?
What year just feathers?
What year just feathers? Go kati go suda kwe kati we kubi yako koko kubadi.
Omofaiso guino kugenda mu depression. Atebi yamanyo kumuntu banga kumuntu go dating. Bogera mu chitante no tsanga ka depression kali makati. Oya just like. No sang no ka depression kali ku side yemu manya ba.
Mukaka
kali
Nange chiganye chyo.
Getting in some shout outs this morning, of course our shout out is going in to His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni. Now, President Yoweri Museveni has directed that the borrowing of funds for national infrastructure development should be ascribed to railway construction, electricity generation, irrigation schemes, strategic roads building, to some aspects of education and health sectors. President Yoweri Museveni was speaking during a meeting with the African Development Bank Regional Director in charge of the Eastern Africa Regional Center, Mr. Gabriel Negutu, at State House Entebbe. President Yoweri Museveni clarified to the meeting that the construction of the railway is crucial because it will link Uganda to the neighboring countries such as DRC and South Sudan. He also noted that for electricity generation, the current power supply is not enough because the dynamics of the internal economy in Uganda consumes it all. The ADB regional director, Mr. Gabriel Negutu, on his part, concurred with President Yoweri Museveni and said that the funds ought to be borrowed and managed for strategic sectors in the economy, he advised. I think this is a good thing. It will definitely, you know, reduce on the rate at which the country has been borrowing. Mm. We understand we have a debt of about 42 trillion Ugandan shillings, which at the end of the day has to be paid by us.
We keep talking about debts, but we forget the people who borrow on our behalf. And it really, you know, baffles me when someone goes to China and borrows on behalf of Uganda without consulting
Ugandans. You people have been recolonized.
No,
Ugandans have been, you know, consulted by the MPs that they sent to Parliament.
When?
Because that's
when? Has your MP ever consulted you about anything? Anything?
Naye mulaba, eh?
Here,
you guys, we are living in a very, very rich country. I am one of those people from the school of thought of ebintunga masanyalaze, we don't even need to dig more dams, surely. Ebintunga amazi, we should be able to harvest this water. I mean, if we harvested all the water that is drowning us, that water would be going to a very, very good use. Then our waste management, surely, tuba tusobola okufuna masanyalaze mbintunga ebyo na byo na bayo, eh? Biogas, tusobola okufuna masanyaze gas solar. I mean, tuli mu tropics. But this money they are borrowing, yes, we need the railway line. But nene yafe, well, anyway, well done.
Railway gena kuja. But, the thing...
We are yet to see.
The thing is that, first of all, we inflate prices and costs of projects. And secondly, there are people who are No, that's not inflation. that's a different story. Then there are people who want to gain from some of these monies that we borrow. So Sanganti, a project will cost about, for example, let's just say 100 million shillings. And someone says, Anza procuring Zeno and Odeti, Njagara Commune with Sonevazongeramu. Aha, we now gamba, engineer, I got a Korea Commis, Nevazongeramu. So bargain of borrowing, I'll be million if you sat.
Ebio, Kakati,
if you Google, and I think all of you saw it on WhatsApp, Google the most expensive road in Uganda. That's the Entebbe Express Highway. When you get on it,
Kuliko ne ba magazine na kuzino n'olw'ensonga yo tugende kubana abatuletedde medical drones. Dr. Susan Nabada, the executive director of National Health Laboratory and Diagnostics. The health experts have advised the government to deploy medical drones so as to ease the delivery of vaccines and blood samples for Ebola hemorrhagic fever. Dr. Susan Nabada, the Executive Director of National Health Laboratory and Diagnostic Services, said drones are faster than any other means of transport in delivering vaccines during outbreaks. Nabada explained that they want responses as faster as possible for an Ebola outbreak. They need to confirm it in time and transport vaccines in the next few minutes. She added that the technology is good, like for outbreaks such as Ebola, outbreaks in the arena.
Hepatitis
they
B.
Take about 6 hours to get samples from Kasese to Kampala. But for drones, it would take a few minutes to get back the samples. But it is a very good idea.
Why are you
negative? I am not negative. I have
seen people pull over my you find the way
no.
It around.
It is a good thing, guys. It is a good thing. But the people we are living. Drone. Neda. Guys, we should separate our political party ideologies. No, don't same way. Right now, actually what you're doing is what causes people to nail each other, which is also not a game because your tone is inciting. We're not supposed to incite each other. We're supposed to agree that we are all Ugandans. You understand? Haven't you seen it happening? Mm. The cameras they put on the cities, mm. you go and look for them. The lights, covers Zabi trenches. You no, walk on the city and the things you...
Specifically the drone.
Kati ene ya drone.
Baja gula drone, bajiwe piloting a yedelik. Egezebule.
Egende mumbaga. Jizigendo kugendo.
And then on this very wonderful morning, I'd like to shout out to the judiciary. Why? Because the judiciary on Monday unveiled a 9 billion shillings digital system to auto track all case files during the trial and update relevant players on progress of cases. Mr. Pass Bijirimana, the judiciary permanent secretary, said the new system, dubbed the electronic court case management information systems, will track the progress of all aspects of a case, from the initial filing through deposition and appeal. Initially, the judiciary was using the court case administration system to dispense justice, a system that Mr. Bijirimana said was prone to corruption. It's a good thing and a bad thing. Mm. Bad thing, because people are going to lose jobs. Mm. Good thing, because, well, we might have to kick out some corruption here and there. Although I think that systems can also be corrupted. Mm. Corruption is for human beings, and human beings can corrupt anything. Mm. You understand? It's like
we are corruptive people.
Ngabo gamba drones. Someone could have an IT guy and corrupt a drone. Naji hacking. So I think that it's a good thing and a bad thing. And
I think
at the end of the day, the judiciary should invest a lot of money in sensitizing its people about corruption, not digitizing and bring all sorts of this technology.
I think if we're talking about digitizing, we should take it right from the beginning. The beginning of what? Eno case ni itandikira wa, itandikira ku police. Omusango wogura omusango with this, let's say your daughter has been raped. You go to police and then you get a reference number. It would be nice if that case, if this digital system starts from the moment the case is being captured. Reference number yo ne yingidamu. Then you can see how long it has taken, which hands it is going through. You understand? Through
to the
cameras putting different police stations. You know, when you
all, those
in,
things, like, all those
they
things,
they have to see the attitude of the person going to attend to you. Balabedi, when you put, you know, that reference number, when you got all those things you need, and maybe you can track it on from there.
All those things
okay, it is hopeful,
can be corrupted.
But,
it doesn't matter what kind of technology you bring. As long as it's being handled by people, it can be corrupted. The issue is not whether it's human beings or machines handling it. The issue is us as individuals.
Yeah.
We need to preach to continue fighting corruption from the, you know, human perspective.
Yes,
for example,
yes.
There was a case, I think it was something like a murder in Kampala, and then, you know, people went to police and were asking for this CCTV footage, and police says in that particular spot, we didn't see anything. So what happened?
Someone corrupted the CCTV cameras. But anyway, there you have it, of course, for the shout-outs coming in right here on Avon today. We want to take a quick look at what is making headlines. Up next is the Press Digest.